Jarvis?
Fly.
Jarvis could do a lot of things, from sending Tony a suit from orbit to helping him discover a new element. But even Jarvis never flew a fighter jet completely on its own. Although we're sure it's not any more difficult than the things Jarvis has done in the past, it raises an interesting question. When it comes to the most advanced aircraft in the world, fighter jets, would you hand the controls over to AI? That's what we're exploring today on Get Around How, your favorite channel for all things new and exciting in the world of vehicles. Stick around to the end if you want to know about how China and Russia are already threatening the US with their own advancements in AI. Almost as soon as the Wright brothers proved flying was possible, people started to look for ways to automate it. Just 9 years after the first flight, a man named Lawrence Sperry created the first successful autopilot, which automatically balanced the plane during flight so the pilot didn't have to. Before long, pilots everywhere added the device, nicknamed George, to their aircraft. The commercial air travel boom in the 1950s was another push toward automation. Planes needed 5 crew members in the cockpit to fly. A flight engineer, a radio operator, a navigator, and 2 pilots. Within decades, automation technology made the first 3 jobs obsolete. The decades that followed introduced all sorts of new automation on airplanes after a 1970s study showed most plane accidents were caused by human error. But the new technology hasn't been loved by all. In 2009, an Air France flight crashed into the Atlantic Ocean after the autopilot and fly-by-wire systems malfunctioned, and pilots couldn't take over manually. Yikes. Still, engineers and scientists continue to introduce new technologies to airplanes, including artificial intelligence. From the simple task of cleaning planes, to complex flight planning and maintenance, AI has already shown its abilities in a range of low-risk aviation jobs. However, the development of truly autonomous aircraft has been slower to take off, with only small-scale tests being conducted so far. In 2019, Boeing successfully tested a small autonomous passenger air vehicle. And this technology is also being explored by Chinese company EHang. Silicon Valley startup Reliable Robotics has secured significant investment for developing autonomous cargo planes. Swiss software developer Daedalian is using machine learning and neural networks to develop visual navigation systems that could lead to the age of pilotless commercial aircraft. Airbus has also made a groundbreaking advance with their autonomous taxi, takeoff, and landing system, which uses advanced image recognition software. And the military sector has made strides in autonomous flight, with Boeing demonstrating how uncrewed military aircraft can operate together through data sharing. But is AI really capable of flying fighter jets? If so, why haven't we made one yet? Actually, we have. Sort of. On February 14th, the US Department of Defense's research agency, DARPA, announced that AI algorithms can now control an F-16 in flight. AI software was uploaded into a specially modified F-16 test place, known as the X-62A or VISTA, Variable In-Flight Simulator Test Aircraft, and flew multiple flights over several days. This project has been in the works for a while. In 2019, DARPA launched its Air Combat Evolution, or ACE, program to work on human-machine collaboration in dogfighting. The following year, ACE hosted the Alpha Dogfight Trials, a competition between companies to see who could create the most advanced AI for a fighter jet. The algorithms were tested digitally. Airplane avatars the size of a dime move around a screen, mimicking a dogfight between F-16s. Then in May of 2021, they tested AI on an L-39 Albatross over Lake Ontario. A pilot was behind the controls in case of emergency, but engineers on the ground coordinated every pitch, turn, and roll of the aircraft for 2 hours. ACE's next goal? Have 4 AI-powered L-39s participate in a live dogfight. They're hoping it can happen by 2024. And the recent tests of AX-62A VISTA show that the US already has AI capable of flying for long periods, 17 hours in one test. But there are still loads of obstacles in the way of AI becoming the new de facto fighter jet pilot. One of the biggest hurdles AI faces in any cockpit, especially fighter jets, is pilot trust. Fighter pilots spend years learning how to safely fly these mega machines in the most insane conditions imaginable, and convincing them that AI can take over that job isn't easy. There's a saying in the military that trust is gained in teaspoons and lost in buckets. For example, AutoGCAS, an automated ground collision avoidance system that takes over if a plane is in danger of crashing, received skepticism from pilots for years. The reason? During testing, AutoGCAS has a tendency to pull up suddenly without cause. Those kinks have long been since ironed out, but pilots didn't trust it for years. The deep suspicion of AI flying jets isn't unwarranted. The human brain is still far superior to any AI system when it comes to making split-second decisions in high-pressure situations. A pilot's ability to read and interpret their environment, recognize patterns, and react quickly is unmatched. And while AI can process information at incredible speeds, it still lacks the intuition and creativity human pilots possess. It would likely take years of flawless testing for pilots to trust AI to outperform them in combat situations. And many pilots worry that AI systems will put them in positions far closer to danger than they are comfortable with. When you're in a plane flying 500 miles per hour, you want to feel like you have control over it. So what if you pulled the pilot from the plane altogether? That's what many experts are proposing. After all, without a human to worry about, trust doesn't matter. In theory, fighter jets could be redesigned in the future. Smaller, more agile, and able to reach speeds and execute maneuvers humans can't tolerate. It takes years to train a single fighter pilot to fly. But AI-piloted planes could mean the military can scale at a tremendous pace. AI itself presents another obstacle. It isn't easy to program a computer to respond to every possible scenario. In combat situations, countless variables can affect the outcome of a mission. An AI system would need to adapt to changing conditions, anticipate threats, and make decisions in real time. Planes fly differently at different altitudes and angles, and even at different temperatures. That's tough enough for AI, without adding in the environmental threats a plane would face in combat. Human pilots can respond to completely unimaginable circumstances, while AI is limited by its program. Even if pilots could fully trust an absolutely flawless AI or get out of the cockpit altogether, there is a bigger problem many people are still concerned about: the ethics of AI warfare. While a computer may be able to make decisions based on data and algorithms, it lacks a human's moral reasoning and empathy. There's a risk that an AI system could make decisions that are not in line with international humanitarian law or military ethics. With AI technology, humans are further removed from the actual battlefield. Good, in theory, for the troops, but also concerning. It's much different making a decision about firing a weapon when you're looking at a computer screen safe on the ground somewhere, than when you're strapped into the cockpit of a fighter jet. Will combat become the equivalent of playing a game over Xbox Live? And what about using AI jets against enemies who lack that technology? Is it ethical to pit a real human with all their soft-heartedness against a non-feeling machine? Some would argue that all military advancements present this problem. Stop Killer Robots, a coalition of more than 180 non-governmental organizations like Amnesty International, has urged nations to adopt a legal treaty controlling the use of lethal autonomous weapons. The US has not signed it. An Air Force run entirely by AI isn't likely anytime soon, but it's not out of the question to think we could see some of these pilotless planes in the skies alongside other jets. They could be used when humans aren't necessary to the mission's objective, keeping pilots out of the sky in risky environments. AI planes and other AI weapons may also be developed as a matter of deterrence against large-scale threats like China and Russia. In recent years, China has boasted about its own use of AI technology in its fighter planes, claiming in 2021 that its AI had become so advanced that it could defeat its top pilots. Chinese officials also told media outlets that AI is being incorporated into their pilot training programs, and is seen as not only a tool for combat, but also a measuring stick for which their human pilots can compare themselves, and hopefully be motivated to sharpen their own flying skills. They claim their AI technology has grown so advanced because it learns from every human-piloted jet it encounters. Any move or technique that thwarts the AI once won't do so again, and the AI can then use it on its enemies too. Because the US has yet to test its AI against humans, it's hard to say how their AI compares to China's. And if you want to see how the US is racing to keep up with China's hypersonic technology, check out our other video by clicking that pop-up above. Russia has also claimed to be adding AI technology to their fighter jets. At an air show near Moscow in 2021, the new Checkmate single-engine light tactical aircraft, or LTS, was unveiled to the public. The Checkmate supposedly has the most extensive flight range for light craft and extended duration for hovering while searching for or waiting on a target. It is also claimed to have the highest carrying capacity and best onboard equipment. But the AI in Checkmate is not intended to replace the pilot. Instead, its designers say it will help reduce pilot workload, enabling him to concentrate on combat. Do you think these jets will have bumper stickers that say, "AI is my co-pilot"? The plane's designers say an uncrewed version may show soon though, and would be able of operating in groups of crewed and uncrewed aircraft. If other countries are rolling out AI fighters, it's only a matter of time before the US begins to incorporate them in some capacity. After all, nothing fuels American innovation like competition from China or Russia. Thanks for watching.